हेलो
So while we are all waiting, I want all of you to pay attention to one small feature called the closed caption. So the closed caption is a little different from the chat box. So the chat box can sometimes be cluttered with a lot of messages. So any kind of official messages that we want to disseminate for all the participants, that's very important, especially related to technical terms, we will be using the closed caption. Okay, so what I am currently going to type is just say hello on the closed caption. So you will see under the control panel a closed caption button or CC button. I'll just type a test message on that. So this is something like a CCTV closed caption. So you should see welcome to the workshop. Okay, so you may see a option on the closed caption saying that show CC messages or something like that. Okay, so this is where important information will be conveyed. So just keep an eye on that. Thank you for your attention.
dear participants. Hello, Kanan sir.
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir. Yes, you are audible.
Yeah, thank you, sir. My dear participants, good afternoon to you all. On behalf of the organizing committee and Krishna University, I take the privileged opportunity to welcome you all for the opening ceremony for the today national level online workshop on modern methods for remote teaching learning practices organized by Krishna University in association with Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education. This workshop is planned due to outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic with a view to create awareness among the faculty fraternity, universities, colleges, and other reputed institutes across the country on various online tools, opening resource softwares, opening educational resources, and other digital tools. Firstly, I thank all the faculty participants for your huge response and interest on our workshop. But we are able to accommodate only 1,000 members for this workshop. My sincere apologies to those who have not got a chance to participate. At this juncture, I thank Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, Chairman, AP Council of Higher Education, and Professor K. B. Chandrasekhar Garu, Vice Chancellor of Krishna University, and Professor K. Krishna Reddy Garu, Registrar of Krishna University, for their support and encouragement to organize this workshop in a useful manner. Now, Sir Registrar, sir, is available there? Okay, thank you. Now, I request a conventional university has take initiative to organize workshop on a technical theme, that to a topic which suits to the present environment, which has happened only because of our beloved Vice Chancellor, Professor K.B. Chandrasekhar Garu. I request the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Krishna University to deliver welcome address in the inaugural session, please. Sir, VC sir, please.
So, my dear participants, video.
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
So, my dear participants, good afternoon. I welcome you all for the today national level workshop on modern methods for remote teaching learning practices. At the outset, I thank to our chief guest, the Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, the chairman, Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education, for readily accepting our invitation for the association of APSKI to this workshop and for supporting the idea of organizing a workshop on topic of the contemporary relevance. As you are aware, the outbreak of a pandemic COVID-19 has affected almost every sector of the economy of all the nations across the globe. Education is not an exception to this. Every sphere of academic activity has suffered a lot. As a matter of fact, COVID-19 has severely hit the education sector at a crucial juncture. COVID-19 has taught many lessons and entirely changed the perspectives towards the several aspects. The educational institutions across the world are slowly recovering from this unexpected eventuality and reviewing and redefining their approaches. Unfortunately, the educational institutes, particularly in the developing nations, are following a traditional teaching learning practices for various reasons. They are lagging behind in using the latest technology in their teaching learning practices. The latest pedagogical tools and techniques, the technology enabled, the teaching learning practices are vital in creating an active learning environment. Against this background, this workshop is contemplated with view to create awareness to the participants on various online tools, open source software, open educational resources, and other digital tools. This workshop will enable the participants to learn the classroom management strategies through technology enabled teaching and also empower the participants to adopt online assessment strategies in teaching learning mechanisms. I think it is the need of the hour, as we are still in the clutches of a COVID pandemic and expecting the freedom from it. I am really happy with regard to the response to the workshop from the faculty across the nation. So within 24 hours of release of this webinar flyer, the more than 2,000 participants have the registered, and within 48 hours, the registrations has crossed the 4,200. Literally, we have stalled the process of registration in view of huge response. I am continuously receiving the request through the mobile and email to accommodate in the workshop. Really, it is an amazing response from the participants. It shows that the faculty members are ready to update themselves and try to cope up with the present trends. I appreciate your commitment, sincerity, and dedication towards the teaching profession. In view of our own limitations, we have accommodated the 1,000 participants only and not able to accommodate all the registered and interested participants. Looking at the two-day program itinerary, which is sent to all the participants, I feel that it is going to be an information-packed workshop, along with the required inputs on remote teaching learning practices. I was told that the participants will also have the hands-on experience on various the digital tools and softwares. Once again, I welcome you all the today national level workshop. Before I sign off, I once again thank the Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, the Chairman, Andhra Pradesh, the State Council of Higher Education, the Professor K. Ramamohan Rao, the Vice Chairman APSCI, Professor T. Lakshmamma, Vice Chairman APSCI, the Professor B. Sudhir Prem Kumar, the Secretary APSCI, for their a wonderful cooperation in making this workshop useful to the participants. My wishes and appreciations to Dr. D. Lakshmi, the key resource person of the workshop and the organizers. So stay home and stay safe. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your inspiring messages, and always you are behind us. Without you, it may not be possible, sir. Thank you so much. Now, a man with vision, commitment, dedication, providing leadership to the higher education in Andhra Pradesh, he is none other than Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu. Now, I proudly invite Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, Chairman of the State Council of Higher Education, to deliver inaugural address. Sir, Chairman, sir, please give.
Yes, I am here. Thank you, Ramshekar. At the outset, I extend my warm greetings to the respected Vice Chancellor of Krishna University, Professor K.P. Chandrasekhar, the Registrar of the University, Dr. Krishna Reddy Garu, and the Director of this program, Suri Chandra Rao Garu, the Convener Ramshekar, and the key resource person here, Dr. Lakshmi Garu, other distinguished dignitaries, all the participants. My warm greetings to you all once again. And thank you for the opportunity given. I think a couple of weeks back, Honorable Vice Chancellor requested me for an opportunity to organize a webinar of this nature. I readily agreed because, you know, the COVID is demanding such new solutions. I'm very, very happy that Krishna University could take a lead, and it's first of its kind, and immediately Nagarjuna University followed. They also conducted one webinar yesterday. So at the outset, I congratulate the entire team from Krishna University for taking this initiative. Yes. Now, my dear friends, from the APSCI point of view, I at the outset extend the best wishes from the entire APSCI team to all the participants and the organizers of this program. I wish this program to be a grand success. And just to draw your attention to the fact that, you know, the modern, you coined this title as modern methods for remote teaching and learning practices. There is nothing like modern methods. Methods are plentifully available. At least when you talk about ICTs, I'm listening, discussing about ICTs for the last 1.5 decades very seriously in the entire academia. And there are many workshops organized. But as the Vice Chancellor was rightly pointing out, we, for reasons best known to us, we just continued with our traditional teaching learning method of chalk and talk inside the classroom. And many of the teachers in various universities, we never resorted to the use of tools to improve the effectiveness of the teaching learning process. Probably, even if you ask me personally, I still believe that the traditional method of teaching learning is quite effective in driving a concept to the student. But at the same time, properly supplemented tools, the concepts can be driven very, very effectively to the student. And maybe you can use the animations, maybe you can use attractive figures, you can use the complicated equations, There are many things are you can assemble the best possible examples, live examples and videos. You can try to convince the student. But very unfortunately, this did not happen for a very long time, though everyone started talking about the necessity of using ICT, but then we did not take a very serious keen interest in this. And blessing in disguise, COVID now is forcing us to talk about this use of technology tools, technology-enabled learning at a bigger scale. So quite naturally, COVID is posing a real threat to the entire community as such. And, talk about our own area of teaching learning process. It is going to be an uphill task for the entire educational administrators in the state of Andhra Pradesh to ensure that every kid, every student is COVID safe and still continue their teaching learning process. And our Honorable Chief Minister was mentioning that we need to learn to live with COVID for some more time until when a permanent solution is identified. So the start of academic year is around the corner sometime in July. The UGC schedule suggests that we should start conducting the examinations, and thereafter, from the 1st of August, we need to start the classwork for the senior students at least. And the UGC schedule is also talking about starting classwork for the new students, the fresh batch of students, from the 1st of September. Now, having said this, we have to face many such serious problems in view of the COVID. The social distancing is to be ensured in the classroom. Social distancing is to be ensured in the transport, the buses which transport students from various places to the university or the college, and particularly the hostels. We all have created only just bare minimum facility to accommodate all the students in the hostels. Now, all of a sudden, if situation demands that students, there shall be sufficient space and gap maintained between the students, quite obviously, it becomes very difficult for the entire university to ensure social distancing and run the classwork and the hostels for the students. Now, the situation really demands a blended learning, the traditional chalk and talk and followed by the ICT-enabled or technology-enabled learning. So this both these things should go together to make things very effective and safe for the institutions to run. At least we need to practice this for the next 1 year. I'm sure when you practice this for next 1 year, it will be, into the belief system of the teaching community, into the practice and the teaching community will start, this is forcing us to use, teaching community will start using, they break their shackles and start using this ICT. And probably the mixed mode of learning will take momentum after this when we start the academic year for the students sometime in July or August. So This is the right time, and I'm told you are drawing very good, experts to deliver their message and deliver the content to the participants of the webinar. As I could see, it is already 725. At least I have never addressed 725 students in, I mean, the participants in one go in any kind of a seminar before. And then see, effortlessly, with the situation, I mean, a platform has been created to address 736. And also, what makes this very impressive is, imagine the number of working hours that we could save. If all the 725 participants had to travel to Krishna University from their places, how much of time they would have spent, how much of money they would have spent, all these man hours are saved now. And with relative ease, the organizers also, I'm sure, agree with me, the entire expenditure to be incurred to organize such a webinar is almost nominal or minimal as compared to the traditional workshops what we have been conducting in the universities. Now, the advantages are already, people started realizing the advantages of using ICT in the teaching learning process, and definitely we need to go with it. Like your Honorable Vice Chancellor was rightly pointing out, the assessment tools, we are using it to the bare minimum. And in fact, if you ask me straight away, we are absolutely not using it at all. The assessment tools are to be used extensively. And today, we are struggling to conduct our examinations online. And there are two aspects to it. One is the creation of the infrastructure. Number two, the accessibility to the student. But in spite of that, we can think about, slowly, implementing the assessment tools, the best possible assessment tools. And we may start with platforms like Kahoot initially, to share or test the student on the objective mode. And slowly we can build up the capacity to test the student in a conventional mode too. Probably we need to explore the possibilities, and I request Krishna University to extensively work on this, explore the possibilities, at least initially extend the assessment tools to assess students' internal performance. And later on, we can apply it to university or end semester examinations as well. So I don't want to take much of your time. There are 720 participants already, and there are many experts are drawn to this program. I am given only 10 minutes slot. I think I've consumed my 10 minutes. I really, really thank the administrators of the Krishna University for coming forward to organize such a wonderful program. And for all the organizers, my appreciations. And for all the participants, look, you took a very nice, smart move of participating in such webinars. There are many more to come in the future. Get ready for this. And knowledge will come to your house straight away through your gadget. And get ready, be open to receive the knowledge. And I'm sure Krishna University, with this kind of a momentum you have given, will go a long way, in changing the whole system. And probably you will be transforming from traditional chalk and talk teaching to the blended teaching, maybe in a few months to come. And get your students ready for that. And before that, I make an appeal to all the university administrators. Please concentrate, educate, and impress upon the entire teaching community of the within your purview, both your own university teachers as well as the affiliated college teachers, to resort to this kind of blended learning and let the students reap maximum benefits. And I still believe that this is a blessing in disguise for us. COVID has started teaching many lessons to us. One is this, taking the technology further in the teaching learning process. And I wish all the participants a very good learning experience, and appreciations to entire university people. And my special thanks to the resource persons who have accepted to be here and taken time to deliver their lectures. I wish I can stay connected and listen to the resource persons. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Over to Krishna University.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your inspiring message and valuable directions. So we will follow the APSHI guidelines and APSHI suggestions, and we will always work with you, sir. Thank you for your support always. And now this is time to introduce our key resource person, Dr. Lakshmi Madam Garu.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Sir, one second. Registrar has joined, sir. Okay.
Sir, Registrar, sir, welcome you to this today's workshop. Sir, I request you kindly give your inaugural message, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Ramshekar.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
It's okay. Good afternoon to all the participants from nook and corner of Andhra Pradesh and nearby states. Professor K. Hemchandra Reddy Garu, Chairman, Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education, Krishna University Vice Chancellor, Professor K. V. Chandrasekhar Garu, Workshop Director, Professor Surachandra Rao Garu, Workshop Convener, Dr. Ramshekar Reddy, and Online Web Resource Team headed by Dr. D. Lakshmi, Educational Research Officer, and other invited guests, cordially invite you and welcome you to the two-day national workshop on modern methods for remote teaching learning practices organized by Krishna University in association with Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education in webinar mode. We are proud to announce that it is the first of its kind organized during the severe crisis of COVID-19 pandemic sporadic spread across the globe. At the outset, we are very much thankful and indebted to Professor Hemchandra Reddy Garu, who is a guiding force for academics and research in Andhra Pradesh. His dedicated and untiring efforts with able leadership brought several reforms in academics and also administration of Andhra Pradesh state universities with a rapid and constructive progress. We can witness now the dynamical changes, and the stakeholders of the state profusely applauded and appreciated him. On behalf of Krishna University and my own behalf, please, sir, we are very much thankful for delivering the inaugural address for this today webinar workshop. We are very much grateful to our Vice Chancellor, sir, Professor K.V. Chandrasekhar Garu, who is a cheerful person with a lots of enthusiasm, fascination, commitment, determination, with a roadmap for the inclusive growth of the Krishna University academics, research, and administration. Professor Surachandra Rao, the director, Professor Department of Business Management, is the man behind this activity, and also it is his brainchild. Due to him, we are all assembled here and witnessing this webinar workshop. His deputy, Dr. D. Ramshekar Reddy, a workshop convener, is in a and head department of chemistry, Krishna University. He's listening for this workshop and also selecting the participants, smooth conduct of the webinar, and also distribution of the EU certificates after successful completion of the 2 days workshop. We are fortunate to have Dr. D. Lakshmi, Educational Research Officer, Vishnu Educational Development and Innovative Center, Hyderabad, and her team for accepting to host online classes through Zoom cloud app. We know that we have more than 4,200 participants were registered in a couple of days of the when we launched the webinar player. But due to the several constraints, technical reasons, and the bandwidth issues, we could able to restrict to up to 1,000. Now at this juncture of time, we are having 731 + 1, 732 members are now online. They are listening my voice now. So, you know, our vice chancellor and Hemchandra Reddy Garu pointed out the main objective of this workshop is to create awareness to the participants and faculties on various online tools, open resource software, open educational resources, and other digital tools. We firmly believe this workshop will be immensely beneficial to the teaching family. Moreover, the prevailing situations due to coronavirus and greater advancement of the digital and multimedia communication, it is high time to teach our wards in coming days through, and also for the academic year 2020 to 2021, also at least 30% of the syllabus. In near future, the faculty and administration has to plan for online examinations after a couple of years. It is necessary to change the academic as well as statutes of the varsity. Wishing this two-day national workshop in webinar mode a grand success, hoping for a few more webinar conferences, symposias to be conducted in near future by the faculty of the Krishna University with novel approaches and methods and tools. Thanking you, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your inspiration speech. Thank you so much, sir. Now, this is the time to introduce our key resource person. She is Dr. D. Lakshmi Madam, a lady with a lot of dynamism and knowledge, having rich experience in handling this type of webinars. And I request Dr. L. Sushila Madam kindly give a few words about Dr. D. Lakshmi. Please introduce to the participants. Sushila Madam?
Yes, sir.
Please.
Good afternoon to one and all. Thank you for providing me the opportunity to introduce Dr. D. Lakshmi Madam, resource person of our two-day national workshop on modern methods for remote teaching learning practices, organized by the Krishna University in association with AP State Council of Higher Education. Dr. Lakshmi Madam is associate professor at B.V. Raju Institute of Technology and also has been torch-bearing as the educational research officer at Vishnu Educational Development and Innovation Center, run by Sri Vishnu Educational Society, Hyderabad. She has been contributing to the educational sector since 1998. Her research areas are educational technology, educational data mining, virtual education, and educational psychology. She has been actively involved in educational research and published many research papers in various peer-reviewed journals. As an educational officer, she is actively involved in conducting workshops to foster quality initiative, quality sustenance, quality improvement in higher education, and e-learning initiatives. She completed her doctoral degree from Anna University, Chennai, and M.Tech in Computer Cognition Technology from University of Mysore, and B.E. in Computer Science and Technology from BRS College of Engineering, Madras University. She started her career as a software instructor in a computer academy located in a remote town, where she worked for the empowerment of girl students from poor village background. And still she is continuing and extending her support remotely. Later, she held various roles from lecturer to professor in many engineering colleges. Besides teaching, she also played the role of staff advisor and provided guidance to thousands of students. As a faculty at Ames Institute, she gained international exposure in handling various courses to international students. With this experience, she had brought her new insights on educational methods in the context of geographical and cultural differences. She is also advisory member for various accreditation bodies like NBA, NAC, LIC, etc. She was the first Indian woman author to publish a book on theory of computation. She had reviewed several books for Tata McGraw-Hill and Pearson Publishers. She also has a patent on dynamically understanding 3D visual scenes using deep learning. She has built a software model named KYC, Know Your Caliber, based on biopsychological potential grounded on the cognitive features such as brain dominance, learning style preferences, multiple intelligence, and personality. Madam is a continuous learner and with great passion to mentor students with holistic approach. She gained adequate knowledge in other branches such as life sciences, food and nutritional science, cognitive science, yoga and meditation, educational psychology, and educational technology. Thank you, Madam, for accepting our invitation and be as a resource person for our two-day workshop. Hope we all will enjoy our sessions. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sushila, madam. Thanks for your kind words about the resource person. And now the floor is open to Dr. Lakshmi, madam.
Respected higher officials of State Council of Andhra Pradesh Higher Education, higher officials of Krishna University, and all other special invitees, delegates, and my dear faculty members, good afternoon, one and all. I welcome you all to this 2 days workshop. Let us enjoy the journey of these 2 days discussion. So today, I wanted to start with why digital learning, what is TPACK framework model, types of digital learning, art of online teaching, how to choose a software. With this, we will move on to the software discussion. Subsequently, we will move on to the hands-on practices. Why digital learning? Who made to transform this digital learning? Whether our government or our leadership? Not at all. The 100% digital learning is transformed by COVID-19 situation. This situation made us to move towards completely or partially, as Honorable Chairman sir mentioned, that we are rightly blending the blended learning towards the higher education sphere. So if you look at this small cartoon, what that baby says, our father asks, "Hi sweetie, how was school today?" She is replying that, "All the experiences are shared in my blog. Please read it." That is the situation. Now it's going on. Beyond that, there is a story I wanted to share with you. One advertisement we all would have seen, Tata Sky advertisement. In the advertisement, there is a pregnant lady. She's admitted in the labor ward. She's about to give a birth to the baby. She's feeling painful, but that baby is not coming out. The reason is the baby is arguing with the god Nasser, actor Nasser in the advertisement. "I wanted to take a birth, only those who have Tata Sky. I don't want to go to this parent. Please change my parent." That level, the digital conscious reached. Based on anthropology and the cognitive psychologist, every 10 years, they will be naming the generations. Those who born before 60, baby boomer generation 1. Of 60 to 70, baby boomer generation 2, subsequently generation X, generation Y, generation Z, those who born 2000, digital kids, alpha generation. So the name itself coined as digital kids, based on their social culture, individual belief system, individual thought process. Every 10 years once, cognitive psychologist naming the label for each and every generation. So we may need to sensitize. We also need to transform ourselves. Though we belong to different generation, we need to transform ourselves, incline to the digital. That is why we are moving on to the digital education. The education system timeline, how the evolution of education system has come. Just I'm going to touch upon nothing going to do with this, but we need to remember where we have come from. Vedic education system was the first education system emerged on the planet Earth. Initially, people looked around the nature. They were surprised. Who is the creator? Who is the person behind of this existence of the universe, existence of the river, mountain, etc.? So they started thinking everything like mythological view or philosophical view or psychological view. That is what the great psychologists or philosophers like Aristotle, these all people born and contributed so many things to the human race. Subsequently, Buddhism created different education system with arts and science performances. Music is art, dance is art. So many art they brought and they started teaching. Then sage on the stage. Then lot of other art and skills are brought or transformed by lot of sages on the stage. Those days, teacher is the only transmission of knowledge. There is no other source for knowledge acquisition. Unless otherwise the teacher articulates, that knowledge is not transmitted or transferred to the disciples or learners. The moment printing revolution existed, slow independence happened, self-learning accelerated. There is no highest dependence or 100% dependence of the teacher. Then slowly independent learning, self-learning, that culture started. But whereas now, the knowledge is in the palm. Everybody can gain knowledge in a tip of internet access. So that is where we are. Now what should be our role? How we can create excitement? The knowledge transmission is not only the role of today's teacher. We may need to take care of all other motivation, facilitating, and all other skill set development among students. So that is what our role right now we may need to play. Digital learning requires a combination of technology, digital content, and instruction. So that is what digital learning. We must have some technology, some software, digital content. Content need to be there. Gadget need to be there. Either the tab, or mobile, or laptop, or desktop. Any one of the device we may need to use it. Today's learners are digital native of this beautiful earth. Alpha generation kids are called as digital kids. So we are dealing with alpha generation kids right now, especially. So we may need to incline towards digital. So what and all we can do with digital content? First, we may need to select the software, then evaluate what is our content, what is the way we want to deliver our content, what kind of pedagogical activity we want to do, whether we want to create a content or whether we want to transfer a content or assess our student or conduct learning activity, what kind of thing we are doing, then we need to create a content, organize, archive, arrange it in different order or logical order, communicate, sustain, delete, store, annotate. These are all the various activities we may need to come across when we deal with digital gadgets. What is a merit finally? We can bring a lot of creativity. You will be looking around the minimum, I can say, 10 softwares we will be exploring within these 2 days, but I'll be giving you more than 100 softwares for your own exploration. So by the time you will come to know a lot of excitement. Every day I'm enjoying with exploring new softwares and looking at its features. So a lot of creativity we can bring among delivering the content or transforming the knowledge or building the skill. That is for sure. So that is the power of digital technology, effective pedagogy. Content could be stored and any moment, depending upon their cognitive ability, students kept on re-watching that video again and again. Human being a teacher, we may not be able to transfer the same content consistently more than 2-3 times. We feel bored and we feel frustrated. Whereas the digital gadgets helps us for rewinding or replaying the content again and again. There is no attention deficit problem for the students. Whatever may be their attention power, it is possible with the digital gadgets and digital content or digital technology, we can make any students to be a noble student. It is possible. Collaboration, no need to worry that we are away from each other. We may not conduct collaboration activity. We will be discussing a lot of collaboration softwares. That would help if you administer. Although students are separated among each other, they could able to collaborate. They can go for peer learning or cooperative learning. It is possible. Feedback and reflection. Through digital, it is much better than classroom environment. We can give feedback and reflection. We can give a lot of closure and reflection to our student. Now let us move on to TPACK framework model. What is TPACK framework model? It is one of the famous framework model across the globe, across all the academicians, name it engineering, arts, science, and mathematics, and management studies, all the branches of, or all the disciplines of higher education, instructors, they are using this TPACK framework model. 21st century teachers are expected to have minimum these two knowledge. We are all termed as 21st century teachers or instructors. We must have 3 desirable knowledge. One is content knowledge. For the content knowledge, every one of us would have spent minimum 6 years for your UG degree and for your PG degree. If at all doctorate, more than 10 years you would have spent for gaining your content knowledge. Content knowledge, what is your specialization? Name it economics, mathematics, physics, or language. So that is what your content. So we would have spent minimum 6 years to acquire this knowledge. We got this job opportunity just because of this content knowledge. We would have been screened through a lot of or series of interviews, presentations, or test, or written test, or MCQ test. Through that, we all have got this profession or job. So that is the first desirable knowledge to be a teacher. The immediate knowledge required after becoming a teacher, pedagogical knowledge, right from curriculum design, course design, and how to create a us how to create a course and how to create a session plan, how to deliver your content in the classroom environment, how to connect with the student related to the topics, and what are all the way we can apply the dynamics in delivering the content in a classroom environment. What is the way we can do formative assessment and summative assessment, how we need to set rubrics and learning activities, how we need to evaluate the students' performance, what is the way we need to communicate with the closure and reflections, etc. So many, and invigilation, question paper setting, and the inspections, all those things put together, it's termed as pedagogical knowledge. It would take minimum 1 to 2 years for every teacher when you take up this profession to understand the entire sphere of teaching learning process. So minimum we need to spend 2 to 3 years for this. Whereas now we are coming to content knowledge, definitely this also requires minimum 6 months to 1 year of becoming expertise in all the sphere of ICT utilization or educational technology, whatever. So minimum we need to spend 6 months to 1 year. So this is the workshop we are creating with a lot of awareness, but it would take me at least a week time or month time. Consistent exploration is the attitude required for the teacher. Then immediately within a week, within a month, you also will become expertise with this bundle of tools and softwares. That's it. So we may need to have investment of time and effort. That is the only request. Now, this is the framework model. Look at Sulman is the person invented this framework model in 1986 to 1987. Those days, there is no internet, no gadget, especially for the teaching learning practices. We cannot bring that kind of features into our classroom environment three, four decades ago. So that they brought PCK model. PCK stands for only pedagogical and content knowledge. Only two knowledge domains are expected from every teacher. Recently, right from 2007, Mr. Kohler introduced one more knowledge component, that is technological component. With that, when we are doing or conducting educational research, every teaching professionals has the rights to conduct a research both in your domain expertise as well as in your teaching practices. So we have the opportunity to conduct research in two domains. While you are writing educational research paper, this framework model would be useful for connecting a lot of dots. Extensive research study, book materials, articles are available with TPAC framework model. You can explore during your NAC and NBA inspection also. The moment you bring one gadget or one kind of software into your teaching intervention, we can put forth, we are using TPAC framework model in the course level or department level or the institution level or in the utility you are using. Definitely we are transferring content to our students. That is what our prime duty. Subsequently, we are having a lot of adequate amount of pedagogical knowledge. The moment we bring technological knowledge, it stands for TPAC framework model. What is content knowledge? Very first knowledge, let us explore in detail. Content about subject. But suppose if you are teaching a chemistry subject, knowledge of chemistry, how much a teacher has, class exercises, how the teacher builds or sets the exercises, what are all the creative examples a teacher brings to the classroom, or analogies, or stories, or real-time applications, and the careful explanations. When we are thorough on these all, it's termed as content knowledge. A mere thoroughness on the content subject, common content knowledge, horizon content knowledge, specialized content knowledge. We used to say, I'm very good at medical image processing. That one word where you are very sharp, although you are good in image processing, specifically where you are good at. Knowledge of content and the students, knowledge of content and the teaching, knowledge of content and the curriculum. All those components or dots we may need to connect for imparting a successful education. Teachers' knowledge about the subject matter to be learned or taught is termed as content knowledge. Subsequently, a teacher need to move towards pedagogical knowledge. It's all about how to create a context how to create experience among learner, how to create reflection. We may need to make them to think, not like a passive listener. We may need to enable their thought process. We may need to convert them as active listener, so that they have reflection or active listening mode, how we can bring action, how we are moving, taking it forward, evaluation, how we are evaluating each and every candidate depending upon their performance. The core business of teaching, learning, curriculum, assessment, reporting, such as the conditions that promote learning and the links among curriculum, assessment and pedagogy is termed as pedagogical knowledge. Beyond that, what we do? Instructional process, learning process, assessment process. All the three we need to take care. Not only the job of delivering the content, what is the way we can mentor each and every student? We can nurture each and every student, whether we can give different material or different learning modalities or different guidances or personalized learning or adaptive learning, any kind of learning practice we can bring in. Then finally, assessment, how we are making them to improve. These are all the domain expertise every teacher need to acquire. That is termed as pedagogical knowledge. Coming to technological knowledge, knowledge about certain ways of thinking about working with the technology, tools, softwares, resources, working with the digital content, e-resources, it's termed as technological knowledge. With that, we move on to the next topic. Many of us may be very new to video creation. Every workshop, teachers tend to text this message regularly in the chat box. What is the way we can improve the video quality content? There is no straightforward thumb rule. Practice, it's a articulation or creating video content with a lot of excitement, with innovativeness or creativity. It's a kind of skill. Skill cannot be taught. Skill could be demonstrated. We may need to acquire skill over the period by practicing again and again. That is the only solution. So first 3 to 4 times of the video could be a scrap video. We can delete it. By watching each and every time, we can make revisions. We can sensitize. If it is real time, I can do video content, how to create a video content material or interactive video content. And only the review process is the matter. We may need to invite our own peers or colleagues or friends to review our own video. We need to get their closure and reflections, and we need to admit that feedback, and we need to take it forward, and we need to refine the content. So this is the only key solution, nothing else. Types of digital learning. Yeah, 1 minute. Yeah, first let us move to types of digital learning. Digital learning, it's a broad term. Within that, we can categorize into flipped learning, blended learning, and e-learning or m-learning. So those who could not able to use laptop and desktop, supposed to use their mobile. The moment they use mobile, it becomes a mobile learning or m-learning. The moment they use electronic gadgets like laptop or anything like desktop, it becomes e-learning. What is flipped learning? Just I will be giving a definition. For more details, I have created a video in detailed discussion. You can watch if you want to practice this model. Flipped learning, normally what we do in our traditional teaching, we do teach. Instructor will be on the dais, will be delivering the content, will be transferring the knowledge or delivering the piece of information. Then students are expected to work out exercises, homework, and projects at home. Now these need to be flipped. Students need to learn the content at home, either in the form of reading material or in the form of watching videos or audio materials. While they come to the class, more interaction should happen. Either the interaction can happen with their own peers or the interaction can happen with the instructor, so that active learning activities we can conduct, project or prototype or discussions or clarifying their doubts, providing feedback, closure and reflection, and grouping them based on their interest and based on the level of learning, we can personalize the way we can mentor that particular student or group of students. These are all those things we can take care. Very first, this flipped learning is introduced by Salman Khan, who is the founder of Khan Academy, for establishing his own virtual academy, he started coining or published a white paper on the title Flipped Learning, how it needs to be conducted and what is the merit of using flipped learning model. Most of the advanced universities, Western countries started adapting flipped courses, entire course. They will be creating tailored content, very majestic way or curated content they will be building. That content will be given to all the students and scheduling also given to the students. They need to learn the content, watch the content. When they come to the class, they will be discussing about applications, example, design, prototype, products, and collaborative activities, learning activities. They will be accelerating their higher order thinking skill in the classroom. Whereas in India, most of the time, we will be articulating or delivering the content or transferring the knowledge. All those higher order thinking skill and brainstorming and developing applications happens outside of the classroom, either with the support of teacher or peers or by themselves. So this is what a slight change we may need to bring. That right time that COVID starts giving a lot of lessons for every one of us. So we may shift in near future, I'm hoping that. The very first university adopted this flipped learning model in 2016 by MEF University, Istanbul. 2016 onwards, only this model became so famous. Blended learning. This is the topic I no need to explain. Our honorable chairman himself explained right proportion of mixing virtual learning and face-to-face conventional learning. Especially in March month when this lockdown is released by the government, we were completing only 60% or 50% of the syllabus. Rest all the syllabus we started addressing through virtual mode in the past 2 months. Similarly, next semester also, we cannot immediately open the classes and we cannot do traditional teaching. Maybe half of the syllabus for the next semester, we will be doing through virtual mode. Subsequently, we will be moving towards the traditional mode. So here, right proportion of blended learning we are using, but not because of abruptly cutting these two. We need to blend, mix and match. Face-to-face teaching, some percentage we need to bring. And virtual classroom, we need to connect with Zoom again. Although the college is open, some amount of classroom interaction can happen with students. And links for the self-learning activity, simulations we may need to show through digital or in the real time, assessment and one-on-one coaching based on their needs and expectation. Because most of the time, our time and energy is shifted towards self-learning activity and remote learning or remote teaching practices, so that in our contact hours, we can make it to be more useful. We can accelerate their level of learning to the next level. E-learning and M-learning. So what is the way we bring, what gadget we use? That depends upon that. We can say that e-learning and M-learning. Now let us see few, quickly we will walk through tips for each and every video content creation or online learning. A very predominant point what we need to consider, pre-planning, rehearsal. We may need to plan a session. What intervention, what kind of example we are bringing in, analogy we are bringing in, or story we are bringing in, what intervention we are going to make, interaction with our students, when we are going to conduct assessment, whether every session you are going to conduct assessment or not, which tool we are using. Plenty of thought process or thinking and planning and scheduling and what else? Rehearsal is required. So that is the very first predominant step required for online class or any class, name it. Define and communicate the minimum tech requirement. Because every time we are learning new devices, new softwares, we will be upgrading, we will be having curiosity. But well ahead, we need to give instruction manual to our students. This is the way the software need to be accessed. This is the way we need to register. All those instructions, guidelines, we need to give them for the betterment. When it comes to online interaction, especially webinars or meeting with the strangers, if you know the student's mindset already, then it is a little bit easier to go ahead. tone is highly important. Relaxed or conversational style or warmer style, cold call, we need to use very cold or warm words. That is a way we can get connected with the students in the virtual mode, because in the real time, normally in Indian tradition, students will have a bit of respect with the teachers. They will have that different body language and mannerism. But when it comes to virtual learning, that kind of fear will not be there, or that kind of attitude will not be there. Then we may need to give warm calling, cold calling. That is a way we can make them. Then engage in delivery. Once in 10 days, you can have 10 minutes, you can plan, you can crack a simple question, you can pinpoint a certain particular student to answer for that, or open choice you can give. One day you can give open choice, another day you can point out a few students to answer to your question, such way that you can make engagement. And choose the content, establish learning objective, both interactive segment as for the entire session. And how we may need to grab the attention, especially when we create video, within 5 minutes we need to retain the attention of the viewers. Otherwise they will close the video and they will move on to some other's video. So we need to, when we are becoming YouTube vlogger, we need to be careful when we create a video. Within 5 minutes we need to grab the attention. So what that we can do, you can start with application or the question which make them to think. You can start with the question also. Then example and analogy we can give, learning motivation, learning objectives we can start with, or through visuals and animation we can start our conversation or the video. And we can start with real-time object or demonstrating some objects or products or projects, that kind of thing, instruments, that kind. Some curiosity we may need to create within that 5 minutes. That 5 minutes we need to grab the attention of the audiences. That always we need to keep in our mind. So such way that the PPT or the plan of your session, you can go ahead. The use of conversation rather than formal, it should become casual, it should become impactful. So more formal will not make them to feel comfortable, so that we can create conversational style. That conversational style will create a lot of personalization, immediacy. Always we may need to use better verbal as well as non-verbal communication. We may need to please them, or they should feel that it is appealing good. It is good to listen to you. So that kind of eye contact, facial expression, posture, proximity, a warm touch need to be given. So this is the way we can connect and we can build rapport in the virtual classroom setup. Then most of the time we need to use, we need to avoid filler words like okay, clear, something, nothing but. So most of us, most of the member will use to use filler words in their conversation or in their delivery. That needs to be avoided consciously. Impact of your video. I have taken from one of the paper. I'm sorry, I didn't quote that paper where I have taken. 7% comes from your words. Impact of your video or the class, 7% only goes for the words or articulation, the vocabulary. 38% comes for your tone, voice. What is the audible volume you are setting? Neither it should be too high nor it should be too low. It should be optimum, pleasing to listen. If we make very louder or shouting or kind of high pitch, that will irritate the listener to listen. So that it should be optimum. So 55% comes from non-verbal communication, so that most of the time do good dressing and up in front of the camera, try to appear through camera mode, through video streaming, try to connect with your students. Otherwise, they may not give more importance for your delivery, so that 55% importance goes to our normal non-verbal communication, that means video streaming. Confidence level, energy level, look at the camera during the session. So these are all the few tips. Although we know consciously we need to go through this point, only then we can do much better. So for every slide, whenever we prepare a content, we need to create index slide. So what we need to give them the outline, what we are going to do. What is the objective of today's discussion? What are the point we are going to discuss? If not possible, how much we will move on, how much we will be discussing in the subsequent session, that clarity we need to give. One slide, if you put terminologies and the definitions, their brain will become very familiar with all the new words, new terminologies, technical word or English word, whatever. Then they will be showing interest to your conversation. Then they don't feel cognitive fatigue. They don't feel strain. They will listen very actively towards your session. They will love to listen to your session because they all familiar with those words. So that is why even in this workshop yesterday, the prerequisite materials are passed on, requested to watch a couple of videos so that most of the terminologies you will become familiar. When you come and attend this workshop, you will feel comfortable. So that kind of slide we need to prepare. And plan well for each video material or each session to grab the attention within first 3 minutes. Within first 5 minutes, we need to grab the attention. They should feel interesting. Something is there in it. We need to be here. This person is for me. They should feel that. So tips to grab the attention. Again, the same what we discussed previously. It is broad. Finally, getting straight to the point instead of giving lot of dilutions, straight to the point we may need to do because internet is consumed. People may not like to listen to the diluted information so that we need to be straight to the point. As quick as possible, we need to give more information in an effective way. So that should be the motto in our thought process. Whenever we feel loss of thought or sneezing, coughing, that advantage in the digital world is we can put a pass, we can give some instruction, or we can create some food for thought our students, and we can go and relax and come back and resume back your session. So even when we create video, it is possible to switch on the pass button so that you can go away, you can relax or refer the material another 5 minutes, you can come back. That advantage is with the digital gadgets. Interact with students through both audio as well as video so that they will be alert also, they will be showing interest also, they'll feel that importance is given to themselves. So that giving importance is more important for every learner so that we can connect with them both either audio and video. Allow for time lag. If they come 5 minutes late, no need to scold them. We can welcome them indirectly. We can say something. So that kind of use warm and cold calls. Consider the chat window. Whatever they post in the chat window, try to consider. Interject discussion at least every 15 minutes. Every 15 minutes, we may need to give them discussion. That is, breakout room is a concept. Whenever you use any of the software, even GoToWebinar, WebEx or Zoom, it has a concept called breakout room. All the virtual softwares has this concept of breakout room. Through this breakout room, you can create a question or project or brainstorming session or a context for the collaborative discussion. Then instructor will not be into that zone. Only your learners are going to be into the breakout room. They will have their own privacy. They will have their own style of conversation and they will complete their discussion. Once the time is over, you can disable the breakout room. You also intervene and you can identify what is their outcome of the discussion. So that kind of interjection we may need to bring. Or you can completely put off, but how they will communicate. If you terminate your session, if there is no breakout of room option is provided, they need to create one more Zoom session among their own team and they need to brainstorm, come back. That is very tedious. So better explore this option, breakout room, in all your correspondences or virtual softwares, whichever you use. Create polls in response. Then and there you can understand their mindset. In the classroom, we will observe. By looking at eyes itself, we can able to understand what is the feel of every student, what they think about you, what they think about your delivery. But here, there is no way to grasp their thought process, their feelings. So that we may need to administer polls and surveys. Finally, practice is the solution. With that, we move on to the tools and software section. Finally, how to choose a software. So which software, the moment I say LMS, learning management system, content management system, more than 100 softwares available across the globe, freely I'm telling, then licensed version all put together 1000 softwares available. So how to choose a software? Every college will have their own culture, their own belief system. Every one of you also will have your own belief system, teaching style. What is the way you are going to deliver the content? Your teaching style, you only knows about it. Learning style, about your learner learning style, you only knows. So you need to think of your own style and your student style and subject matter. What kind of subject we are impacting? Skill-based subject, knowledge-based subject, or logical or problem-based subject. Every subject will become different way of transferring the knowledge, impacting the skills. So we may need to sensitize. These are all the points and we need to pick the tool or software. The beginning or initial stage, whichever the software comfortable, you choose and just go ahead and explore. Once if you become thorough on all the digital technologies, then you can think and pick a software. So whenever we pick a software, we may need to think of these three: technology design, content design, learning design. So these three design of the software, we may need to think and keep in our mind in choosing the software. And what is a technology design? Very first, scalability. The scalability means, although we have got more than 2,000, 3,000 applications for this workshop, it is limited up to 970 yesterday. But although 970 approval is given, 703 only joined. Scalability. The capacity of the Zoom, when we launch, especially Indian infrastructure, more than 1,000, taking more than 1,000, it is very risky. So especially not Indian infrastructure, especially my own infrastructure. So I'm not having very adequate, internet bandwidth. I'm a little bit isolated area I'm living. So it is not possible for covering more than 1,000 participants and at all in this workshop. So scalability, what is the size of the audience? Depending upon that, the software need to be chosen. Suppose if you are using Zoom, it allows less than 100 only for free of cost. If you are handling same subject for two sections, you want to reduce your burden so that you want to combine both A section and B section, then Zoom is not the software for free of cost. You may need to explore. None of the software allows more than 100, I think so. Let me go through the sheet which I have collected. If at all allowing, we are lucky. Otherwise, it allows only 100 participants. The advantage of WebEx is one of the software that through WebEx, Cisco WebEx, you can conduct virtual classes. But what is the advantage is n number of hours it allows freely. After this pandemic situation, I heard that Zoom is also allowing n number of hours freely, not restricted to 45 minutes. So then stability, how it is stable with the internet. So although we have low bandwidth, low internet, or if we have fluctuation, how stable that software is behaving. That is another advantage that we need to explore. There are software which will have beautiful features, but there is no stability. The moment internet fluctuation and bandwidth is going low, immediately it will get disconnected and it will collapse what we were doing. So that we need to explore functionality. So what is the functionality available that all useful for our really for our practices, so for our teaching of a subject, or for our thought process, or for our course design, or the rules which is stipulated by your higher official, whether it meets or not, that we need. Security, fast, how good it is. These are all the minimum thing. The very first bundle is enough. Synchronous, asynchronous means simultaneous or offline also can be done. So these are all the features we may need to explore with the technology. When it comes content, so different varied content we need to give for even a single topic, especially whichever the topic seems to be very tough. We the teacher knows where students will feel struggling to learn that concept. Those particular topics, we need to create different resources like audio resource. We can pick from the internet or we can create whatever. Audio resource, whenever we pick from internet, it's called curated content. The curated content in the sense, we need to verify being a teacher that the content is suitable for our own learner first. whether the students are from first year or second year, third year, fourth year, it matters. Their proficiency in English is also a matter. The technological thought, the acquisition of their knowledge is also a matter. So that we need to sensitize. Then the content need to be free from intellectual mistake. The content need to be free from grammatical or English mistakes that need to be verified. So these are all the process we need to take care. So that role is called curated content. The teacher need to pick the curated content. We need to create a material in different forms and different resources or formats. Why we are creating audio clips? Although the same topic, we need to create one audio clip or video clip, animation, simulation, and reading material if possible. Yesterday I discussed about what learning style. Now visual learner, auditory visual learner, auditory learner, kinesthetic learner, touch kinesthetic learner, read and write learners, reflective learners. Everybody's brain dominance, the brain configuration is different. So each one of us vary in terms of learning. Some of us may be good in visuals. The moment we see something, we will grasp and we will remember. Some of us may be very good in auditory. The moment we hear only, we will feel comfortable. We feel that we learned. So that are all the kind of psychological or brain configuration we need to understand. We need to take care of that. If you are planning learning activity, different softwares that we need to decide, and learning assessment, different software, what activity we are doing, depending upon that we need to take. Then learning design, whether that software we are meant for learner and content interaction, learner-learner interaction, learner and teacher interaction. So these are all the things we need to keep in our mind. These three designs always we need to keep in our mind. Even when you are publishing a paper, you can explore these three designs and write a paragraph, the design of the technological design, learner design, these all. So by the time documentation point of view, these all will be helpful. That's it. So with that, we move on to, this is the software, it's called Prezi. This is one of the presentation software.
Excuse me, madam.
Yes, sir.
Can we have a brief break for a poll?
Yeah.
It will take roughly 7 minutes, so you can take a break.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. All of you, please, thank you so much, sir. So we'll want to have a small poll. The purpose of the poll is mainly to make sure that the pace of the trainer is good, and also to collect information about the participants so that we can also register for the attendance. Okay. So I'm going to open the poll. It will take just 2 minutes. So one of the requirement is you have to furnish your email address, phone number, and name. Please put all of them in a single line so that it is not jumbled with the different participants' messages. Yeah, the poll is launched. So after the poll, you can take a brief 3 minute break. So we will resume the session at 3:33. Okay, so 3:33, we'll start the session. You can take a brief break of 3 minutes. So the poll is over and also the break is over. So some of the participants have felt that the train is a little fast, and also she could give more examples. I think that she's going to do anyways. So I will hand it over to the facilitator, Professor Lakshmi.
Thank you, sir. Welcome back to the session. Yesterday we discussed about what are the tools and softwares we are going to discuss in this session. Most of the software, 90% of the software, what I am introducing is all of open source, free to use for the academician across the globe. And very few software, minimal subscription we may need to do, $5, $10, very minimal amount. Rest all, it's a totally open source. And that point, we no need to worry. We need to map with each and every software with the outcome-based education, with the Bloom's taxonomy, remember level, understand level, apply level, analyze level, evaluate level, create level, how it suits. So Bloom's taxonomy is suitable for almost all the subjects except mathematical subject. When the not only mathematical, problem-based subject, although certain concepts comes in terms of engineering and science, most of the concepts comes in terms of problem-based subject. So by the time we may need to use, you just to make a note of it, mathematics teacher, physics and chemistry teachers or problem-based teaching, even chemical engineering, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, we do have a lot of problems. All the problem-based teaching, we can use Charlie Yokomoto levels of problem solving. This is the suitable levels of learning when it comes problem-based subject. So that we may need to compensate, we may need to. Bloom's taxonomy definitely will not applicable. Never we can evaluate the formula. Never we can create a formula in the given 2 hours of examination, in the given 2 minutes of time. So that we may need to keep in our mind, we need to set the question paper or connect with outcome-based education, Charlie Yokomoto's levels of problem solving. In the entire 2 days workshop, I'll be giving you glimpse either theoretically or with the hands-on experiences. There are around 23 umbrella of softwares, 23 varieties of softwares. So I am telling not 23 count. It's a major title. Each and every software bundle is categorized into a title. So 23 varieties or bigger umbrella level we will be discussing. I just read out, after going through the softwares, we will see. Open source LMS and CMS, learning management system, content management system, software for online classes and interaction, video recording softwares, or software LMS for video-based learning, and presentation software, software for rubrics creation, software for assessment submission, instantaneous assessment software, learning through gamification, mind mapping software, software for visual effects, content creation with a lot of aesthetic effects. So that is the visual effects. Software for peer learning and collaborative activities, software for data collection, online coding platform, mobile apps for coding, and English language learning software, tools for English language, science, maths. Exclusively, I'll be listing out a set of software suitable for science education, means that physics and chemistry, maths education, geography, astronomy. Yesterday, I shared material in all the WhatsApp groups related to physics, chemistry, and English language. For these three subject matter, I shared, and mathematics also I do have in the same blog. You can search, otherwise I will share today. Buzzer system, like how do we create a competitive spirit in a classroom? If we ask a question, who knows first, they'll be raising a hand. Here it is not possible. So here you can use the buzzer system software. They can press that button, then the buzzer, that who is ready to answer first among the students who are attending your session during the assessment. Maybe 60, 70 students attending your session, you can switch over from this, you can switch over to this software, buzzer software, and you can deliver your question, you can articulate your question. Who knows answer further, they need to press that buzzer. Then it will give you a conferences, there will be a buzzer will be there, no? It's a kind of that sound will come. So that the buzzer system will create a lot of competitiveness or enthusiasm among learners for taking part in your quiz answer sessions. Although we use Kahoot, Mentimeter, and praise this what else? So create so many softwares available. This will create different ambience and different environment for their participation. And how to generate certificate? Once if you are administering student with a 20 MCQ question or 40 MCQ questions, at the end with their score, if you want to generate a certificate in the Google form, how to do animation softwares and Google add-ons. There are plenty. I have collected very few, 3 to 5, 5 to 10 for each and every title and category. Then Google add-ons. So add-ons more powerful. If we talk about Google add-ons, Google add-ons means suitable for entire G Suite. G Suite means it's a bigger picture, useful for either business or education. It has varied or numerous products within that G Suite. It's a highest apex name, G Suite, including Google Drive. What I am doing right now is Google Sheet. So this Google Sheet, Google Calendar, Google Doc, Google Slide, Google Classroom, anything starts with Google, that word. All those products combined together, it's called Google G Suite or Google Suite. So Google add-ons and G Suite alone, we need to discuss minimum 3 to 4 days workshop. So here, as much as possible, the awareness and hands-on experiences for every bundle, one software, we can explore. So now let us move on to the open source software. Very immediately, if we go to the hands-on session, what would happen is, it's a kind of larger forum. Beginner to the teaching profession, teachers also available. Senior professor is also available. 5 years teachers also available. 10 years experience teachers also available. I need to moderate, leverage the knowledge of everyone else. So I could see your polling that hands-on is missing or whatever. It's a whatever you are feeling it, every workshop need to set the stage and tone, moderate the leverage, the knowledge of all the audiences. That is what I'm doing now. You may be aware of this all. Some of you may not be aware. We need to wait patiently until we move on to the next topic. It is been designed like that. So it is not meant for senior professors or junior professors or freshers. It's an open forum. It's a larger audiences. So I have planned the session for larger audiences. If at all you not meets your individual expectations, so please pardon me. You need to wait for some more time if you are really having curious. Otherwise, you need to take decision. So now, open source software for LMS and CMS. The prime role of teacher is content creation. Content is the primary role. Now, the moment content is ready, then it's the art of delivery. Then assessment, these are all students' responsibility. We need to conduct, of course, our effort where it goes, creating the content. Next, delivering the content. These are all the two primary key points we need to keep in our mind while during the instructional delivery. For the content creation, if we create content and keep it in our desktop, it's not said to be content management. The moment content is brought to the online mode, web mode, it is said to be content management system. That's it. The same software, when it is used by a teacher, it is content management system. If the same software used by our learners for learning activities or tracking or wandering across that software, it is learning management system. So you can read these definitions. Just I will share these slides in the evening moment itself. The moment the workshop is over, I'll be sharing. The very first software, Google Classroom. I am fond of this Google Classroom product because so many add-ons available for Google Classroom sub-products like Google Doc, Google Drive, and Google Sheet, and Google, what else? These are all other calendar, Google Forms, all other product of sub-product of G Suite has plenty of add-ons. What is add-ons in the sense? Every Google product will work with a certain feature. Additional feature we are expecting, we need to combine couple two different softwares. Only then the other feature is brought to the particular Google product. Then it will help us for exploring what we are expecting. So Google Classroom, the moment we have the expertise of accessing Gmail, that knowledge is more than enough to explore Google Classroom. And next is Dokio's e-learning suite. So this Google Classroom, I will be giving you demonstration in this workshop itself, either today or tomorrow, depending upon the pace of delivery. And next is Docio's e-learning suite. It is also free. It has numerous features. Sakai is another software. 1 minute. Online Moodle Cloud. Moodle, either we can deploy at our institution, or if we don't have adequate infrastructure, we can access online Moodle Cloud. So next, Sakai is another software. It is free and open source. It is also LMS. Content can be organized. Learning activities, learning assessment, assignment submission, all could be brought into one software. The entire portfolio can be created. Learning portfolio can be created easily with that. Next, course sites, ILIAS, A-Tutor, Canvas. Across the globe, Canvas is very famous next to Google Classroom. Canvas is also one of the best software. It is open source. You can make use of it. And ELMS and Cornucopia, OpenEdX, and Chamilo LMS, Pharma LMS, Eli Adami, OLAT. Next, Edmodo. Edmodo is another interesting software. It is also free. Next to Zoom, I like Edmodo. It is easy for anyone to explore in the beginning. If the teacher or learner both are new to that LMS, they can feel comfortable with accessing these all the softwares. Piazza, Canvas, Blog. Blog is the byproduct of G Suite. So blog, whatever the content you are creating, you can create your own blog. Then every blog article you can title, that link you can share among your students, so that you will become social blogger also, as also you will be creating the evidence-based teaching learning practices for your students also. Anything which we teach through digital technologies, it's all termed as evidence-based teaching learning practices. It's all digital stamped. Time stamp is available. We cannot tell that, yes, I did. Where is evidence? Without evidence, we cannot tell I used that software, this software, and timestamp. We cannot cheat also. Exactly 3 o'clock I conducted this workshop means exactly 3 o'clock it will be recorded. So this is evidence-based teaching learning practices, so that this also will be useful for showcasing your content or your delivery, that is blog. WordPress is also another blog. And the social media based learning, Facebook also used for teaching learning practices. Twitter is also used for teaching learning practices. LinkedIn is also used for teaching learning practices. We can create Facebook page, LinkedIn page, Twitter page. We can create a content in our name, brand name. Globally, you all will be visible. The moment we create YouTube, blog, these all, you will be globally visible teacher as well. You are teacher to your own students. So this a tiny passive income also you will get through blog, WordPress, and all the social media learning. That all will lead to a tiny amount of AdSense amount. So through that, maybe in a year, if the viewers are more, you may be able to earn in a year $100 or $200. That is the kind of revenue you can generate. The content need to be original. Entirely, if we take a copy paste from other somebody's blog and we put it in our blog, and Google will create that plagiarism report, then it will deny for AdSense earning or monetization. So we need to be careful in creating, and then somewhere we need to show our creativity, originality, although it is a subject matter. So this is what the content management system. Next, let us move on to software for online interaction. Zoom is the software. Right now we are using Zoom software for the interaction purposes. So the same way we can use a free Zoom software version for conducting class. Zoom is the software useful for video material creation also. So for now, any video which I create, I'm using only the Zoom software. It has flexibility, lot of annotation tools, flexible to bring any other software into it. And whiteboard option is available. Whiteboard has lot of pen colors and text and drawing tips and eraser. These are all the symbols. These are all the possible features we can bring in during the delivery. And beyond that, it will allow different modes of video setting. There are software rigid to the video. Now with a Zoom software, first you can appear in front of the camera, you can articulate for 5 minutes, then you can share the material and your miniature version you can retain, or you can put off your video fully, and whenever you recover to bring your visual conversation, you can bring, and whenever you want to turn off your video, you can turn off. So these are all the features available. It gives more flexibility for this kind of things. Cisco WebEx, it is also allowing 100 participant. If at all Zoom you are using one-to-one meeting or less than very few, 4 or 5 members meeting, it will allow free version, allow n number of hours to communicate. Less than 15 users, Zoom allows n number of hours. The moment we reach more than 50 or 100 participant, it will allow only 40 minutes. Right now I am hearing that it is unlimited. Jitsi Meet, Skype Meet, every feature, every software has its own features. That how you like or not, knowingly, unknowingly, past 4 years, I tend to use Zoom. I'm tuned to Zoom. I started loving Zoom. So that is my drawback. So you need to explore, you need to install. WebEx, what I did, I conducted 2 to 3 webinars through WebEx during this holiday lockdown declaration. WebEx, during audio recording, that entire session is... if we try to record, the break in voice is happening. If we take the recorded copy, most of the things of breaking is happening. I'm not sure whether internet stability at the host end or the nature of the software. We need to explore that all. So every time when we deliver a session with Zoom or these kind of virtual software, there is a record option. Please enable that option. Although you are conducting a class to your students, that all the video will become evidence for your inspection purposes. Also, you can create your own YouTube channel and you can put it there, that all the video, you can clean it and you can roll up, you can do some pre-processing, then you can put it into the YouTube channel. Jitsi Meet, GoToMeet or GoToWebinars, BlueJeans and WebEx Teams, Uber Conference, LifeSize, Circuit, Lark Meetings, BigBlueButton, Google Hangout, Microsoft Team. Microsoft Team will allow only with the same domain. The domain in the sense, gmail.com, only one domain. edu.in, ac.in. edu.in, ac.in is also Google product. It is extended to the Google services, extended to the academic institution. It is not our own institution domain. So it should be into the same domain, only then it allows for grouping or that group meeting, organizational meeting. Prezi video conference. Prezi also allows video conference. It has video recording feature also, video streaming, video conference also. Slack is a software most of the people uses across the globe for webinars or conferences or virtual meet. Powtoon and Prezi video repeated, Google Meet. So recently Google Meet brought a few more features also. And through Google Meet, you will not have whiteboard in the Google Meet. You cannot do annotation. You need to bring different tools into Google Meet for the annotations and the whiteboard. Whereas with the Zoom, it has by default whiteboard and annotation features. So that is a thing we need to explore. Which software we are using, how to compensate. Every software will have everything. Annotation and whiteboard is essential for virtual classes. Whenever we want, we need to scribble, we need to show, we need to draw diagram, we need to spotlight, we need to highlight, and we need to select certain portion. And we need to text something, we need to do something, we need to draw some picture also. So these are all the possibilities we need to see while teaching. It is not a kind of talk or speech. We need to connect with the intellectual content. For that, these are all those cues we can provide through drawings and annotations and text and whiteboard. The moment we want to create whiteboard, we can open a plain board, we can start writing something, and we can text something, we can draw something. So this is the whiteboard, and we can share this whiteboard, save this whiteboard, and we can share. If you look at the Zoom, after creating the whiteboard in the annotation menu, you can see save button. The moment you click the save button, this whiteboard will be saved in our desktop, so that you can share this, it will be saved as an image. You can reuse it, you can create material, and you can post in your WhatsApp group, you can share with your students, anything you can do. So these are all the features we need to make use of every virtual software. So this is a Google Meet over. Next to video recording software, flashback recorder. Yesterday the manual for flashback recorder is shared with you all. Hope you would have installed and you would have experienced with that manual. So this you can use this flashback recorder for webinar recording also. Most of the webinars, they don't give recorded versions or recorded videos, so that we ourselves can record using this. For recording this workshop itself, you can play or enable the flashback record, and it will keep recording whatever it's going on your screen with audio and video. Whatever it's displayed on your monitor, it will be recorded. So using this also, we can create video material. Zoom, what comfort we feel, how we feel about that software is a matter than the features or appreciation of the software. Screen-o-matic, praise video, YouTube live, if you want to create a video, you want to communicate with the people, YouTube live, minimum 1,000 subscribers, there are certain conditions. We need to fulfill that conditions only, then it will allow for YouTube. Then Powtoon, Epic Pen, these are all those things you can use it for video making or video creation. Next, LMS for video-based learning. So I ask you one question. You are creating a video, either your video or eminent professor's video, you want to give it to your student. What is the accountability we can bring among our student? How many of them are watching the video? What is the percentage of video they watched? Whether they understood the concepts of delivery in that video, then and there. Beginning of the video, they may tell one concept. Middle of the video, they may tell application. End of the video, they may give some derivation. What is the assurity that students are understanding that video? How we can introspect that? This is called accountability or management. It is not possible. We need to ask orally. Next day class, I shared the link of that professor, so-and-so great professor, or my own video. How many of you watched? Then we need to go for moral police duty. We need to inquire. But using this LMS-based or video-based software, Edpuzzle, we can create accountability. It will create all the timestamp. What is the moment each and every student started watching the video? What is the percentage of video each student started watching? And we can set the questions across the video. We can set the text among the video. So these are all the features available that is called Edpuzzle. What is the other advantage? Suppose if you are not interested to put your video on the YouTube, Edpuzzle is other option. We can bring the video, and that video is visible only for your students and yourself. Public cannot able to see that video. So this Edpuzzle, what is the advantage? Another method is, if you are not able to conduct a virtual class, most of our students not comfortable by the time. They may be busy with internship placements, or they may be not having internet stability by the duration. Every day, particular hours, we are not able to connect with internet. So by the time, we can create a video that all those video or somebody's video also brought to this Edpuzzle. This Edpuzzle will take care of end-to-end responsibility, how students are watching, when they are watching, every day, what is the percentage of video they are watching. Across the video, we can set the MCQs. Auto-evaluation is possible. So this about the Edpuzzle demonstration also, I have created a detailed video in my YouTube channel. I will be doing in this workshop also. Next, presentation software. We all, most of the time, tend to use PPT. Across the globe, PPT is outdated. People started writing article. So if we want to present to the standard of global forum, or if you are going for abroad conferences, better to use a different software than PPT. That is my opinion. I heard of from few professors who visited from abroad. So Prezi is one of the software which I used, demonstrated for the first 45 minutes I was addressing through Prezi. Mentimeter is another software. Through Mentimeter, we can present to 1,000 audiences only with the Mentimeter. We can assess 1,000 participants across the globe, MCQ assessment. For the free version, it allows only to set 7 questions, only 7. 8th question, it won't allow. Beyond that, if you want to do, we need to go for a subscribed version. And monthly subscription, very nominal cost. Maybe department-wise, you can subscribe that ID, you all can make use of it. Google Slides. then this Google slide is another way of using the presentation. Zogo Show, PowTown, and Slides. Slides itself, the software name. And Zoomit for presentation. This Zoomit is installed any one corner of your video, your screen. You can double click, you can focus and maximize. If suppose you are explaining one particular component through architectural diagram, so that diagram may be very miniature in nature, may not able to be visible by all the learners. If especially if they watch by mobile, they can't see exactly what you have drawn and how the parts are labeled. By the time the Zooms it software, if you install, then that particular portion we can double click with the Zoom it support, then it will magnify. So next is Caligra. This has lot of tiny component. Within this all component, we can create either the form of, it's a kind of Microsoft Word product, doc, PDF, slide, sheet, we used to say, no? It's a kind of product we can create with this support. Tiny.com, this is another software, we can use this tiny.com for template download. It has a lot of templates. So we can download templates. That template, either we can use it in Prezi or we can use it in PPT or any other presentation software. The templates will be useful. Next, software for rubrics. Why rubrics are important? For example, I'm asking all of you to give your presentation tomorrow, 10 minutes. Immediately you will be asking question. On what topic I need to give? How much duration I need to give? How many slides I need to prepare? So this is minimal expectation from the learners. Beyond that, we need to give how we are grading and assessing. Grading and assessing we need to give before announcing or at the time of announcing about the learning activity, not at the end of the learning activity. That rubrics, what basis I will be assessing you all, whether I'm looking at the articulation power, content quality or delivery or confident or your facial expression or usage of English, what component, what feature I'm looking at, that need to be defined and articulated. How many features I'm expecting? Being a human, we can observe about somebody's attribute minimum 3 to maximum 5. Beyond that, we can't observe anybody's attitude in 5-10 minutes. So that we need to apply SMART model, specific, measurable, attainable, time bound, realistic, SMART model. So that way we need to set the expected attributes. Each attribute we need to articulate. In terms of articulation, what is my expectation? In terms of content quality, what is my expectation? That is next step. That is called rubric. Then beyond that, what if at all not fulfilled, or the percentage of fulfillment, 100% one student fulfills, what is the mark I'm going to award? Only 75% he is fulfilling. What is the mark I'm going to award? 50% he is fulfilling. Less than 50% he is fulfilling. What is the mark I can award? That detailed demonstration sheet we need to give. All the NBN Act practices, they're expecting rubrics for each and every activity, each and every component. You may be aware of the rubrics. So this Ruby Star is one of the software, ready-made, it is available. Lot of that articulation is available already. We no need to sit and write that drafting and all. We can plug and play. Those are all the articulations. I will show you the demonstration. Kind of 10-minute software only. Then for what is rubrics, how to create rubric also, I have given the demonstration video in my YouTube channel. iRubric is another software. This has plenty of rubrics. Especially Ruby Star has across all the discipline of education system, engineering, mathematics, science, and management studies, arts. These are all the 5 major domains of education system in India. So among that 5, what are all the activity would be common for these 5 streams? Those activities only available in Ruby Star. iRubrics has domain specifics. If you are commerce specialist, economic specialist, management studies, engineering, computer science, civil, for each and every domain, it has templates and a lot of rubrics. So that is the richness of iRubric. Rubric Maker and the Quick Rubrics, these are all will help. Rubric Maker also has limited number of activities. Then Quick Rubric will create a empty template. We need to fill up. How these 3 softwares behaves accordingly, we can create our own rubrics for new activity or different activity. That is advantage. software for assignment submission, Google Form, Google Classroom, Edpuzzle. Video assignments can be submitted both to Google Classroom also, Edpuzzle also, GitHub for all the coding repository, assignment, project assignment, projects, they can submit to the GitHub. You can verify whether they have demonstrated or reached the set goal of the project, everything. These are other disciplines, I'm not sure. For the computer science, I'm telling, Google Form, Google Classroom, you can, Edpuzzle, other disciplines also they can use, so they can ask them to submit the classroom assignments. During the demonstration, I will come out and discuss you later. Now I'm giving you a walkthrough, a demonstration, what are all the softwares, awareness I'm bringing, then we will be moving on to the software discussion. Google, the next title is instantaneous assessment software. Giving the question or giving the learning activity, immediately assessing them and taking the report and providing closure and reflection. That is instantaneous assessment or assessment software simply. Google Form with the Timeify. With, if you want to set the time, Timeify add-on we need to use, Mentimeter, Plickers, Kahoot. Plicker we can't use for the remote teaching. It is meant for only traditional teaching, synchronous teaching. So face-to-face teaching, Kahoot, SoCreate, Quizlet, Vizia, Poll Everywhere, Edpuzzle, Quizzes, Microsoft Office Forms. So these are all the way we can conduct instantaneous assessment or assignment also we can make use of these all. Learning through gamification, Quizlet. Quizlet, and there is one more English app I will introduce that also resembles the same features. It has 7 ways of learning. It will put them into 7 different ways of learning, your learners, so that it meets out the learning style of each learner. So they will, whichever the way they want to learn, they can feel comfortable and they can learn easily through this. Mind mapping software, how mind map helps learning. Mind map, initially mind map is introduced to the world by Leonardo da Vinci. The digital mind map is introduced to the entire globe by Tony Buzan, B-U-Z-A-N, Tony Buzan. So the digital mind map based, mind map based learning itself a theme across several educational institutions. So how mind map helps learning, I will share the YouTube link at the end of the workshop. You can watch our evening, I'll be giving you a list of materials and today's recorded video session. By the time also you can watch. So Free Mind is a software. You need to install. Once it is installed, no need of internet. It's an offline software. For only installation, it may require. Through this, we can create awesome mind maps, images or PNGs, or with the animation also we can create, but animation we cannot save. Live demonstration with the Free Mind only we need to use and teach. So this Free Mind demonstration is also available in my YouTube. And XMind infographic, you can download from this website, lot of infographics, lot of different statistical way you can demonstrate, or graphical, different figurative methods available, templates available. Concept Draw Mind Map, Evis Thought Mapper, iMind Map, MindJet Mind Manager, whatever the software I'm listing out, everything is free. We need to install in our desktop. Free Mind has online mind mapping software also. We no need to install, directly we can use online also. Software for visual effect, how we can bring lot of visual effect. One is Cool Text, I'll be giving you demonstration for this. Through Cool Text, we can create running heads, lot of decorative running heads we can create. Pinterest, you may be aware, you need to create a large database for image and video. Whatever the image and video, it will be much more aesthetic than the Google images and the Google video. You can subscribe or log in with the Pinterest. This Pinterest has a lot of interesting templates for each topic. You can type after registration, you can type and you can do. I will show you the demo if possible within today itself. Or tomorrow, fully hands-on, no more theory. Today, walkthrough, awareness need to be brought. Cheat sheet, you Google, open the Google, write, type cheat sheet plus the topic, electrical engineering, or stepper motor, you type what topic you are interested. You need to put the plus symbol and type the topic which you are interested. Then it will list out a bunch of cheat sheets. You can crop. If it is allowing you to download, you download. If it is not allowing you to download, snipping tool. Use snipping tool in your desktop. Microsoft product has its by itself. If you have Windows operating system, you can search for this tool, snipping tool. Then using this snipping tool, you can crop even video, mathematical equations of somebody's notes or any part of the internet resource or anything, you can crop and you can bring it. So cheat sheet and Pinterest, if it is not allowing you to download, use snipping tool and crop it. Shutterstock has plenty of images for English language teaching and management studies and psychology studies. They can use this Shutterstock. You will find awesome images for most of the terminologies and expressions. Infographic, again, you can use it for your decoration purposes. Software for peer learning. Wixie will allow for peer learning or collaborative learning. PeerWise also one of the software. WeTransfer is another software. With this, you can create a board having, you can bring one YouTube URL, you can bring one image, you can bring one text material, that all like a board you can create. That board will have a common share link. That link you can share with your students. Then they can click everything and they can able to understand what is what. Then book type. Book type is useful for collaborative writing. Now if both of you or any three of you wanted to publish a paper or book, you can use book type. Collaboratively, you can sit and work. One of you can type, other one can review. One of you can draw, other one can correct it. One of you can draft it, somebody else can do proofreading. So that collaboratively, simultaneously, we can work. Almost book type, what I can say is equivalent to Google Doc, but it has few more decorative features. You can choose a cover page, you can choose the templates and layouts, whereas Google Doc doesn't have those all. Then AWW app and Padlet. I will show you Padlet, my own Padlet, what it is. This is what a Padlet, education technology, Edpuzzle, whatever. It will create a card like, it will create a Quizlet, Ruby Star. So it will have organized way of arranging different elements. If you are talking about two stroke engine, four stroke engine, stepper motor, single phase motor, three phase motor, every four motor, you can create like a template. They will have clarity where you are starting, where you are ending, what are all the element you are bringing in, explaining single phase motor. So this is the kind of thing you can create. So very easy, within 10-15 minutes, you can explore this tool. This, it will be an archival. You can make it as a private also, or you can share among your students and the public also. It is possible. This plus button you need to create. This, using this, you need to create a template. That's it. So you, if you want to upload any document, you can upload. If you want to bring any link, URL, any website you want to recommend to your students or learners to read, you can put here. And you can bring any snap. And you can bring any Google products or images. It has more, see, upload, link, voice. You can imbibe voice or you can bring audio note. Flim also you can attach, snap. WeTransfer, these all almost the same only. Padlet, everything. Place. So this is called Padlet. This is your own Padlet. My Padlet name is Educational Technology. Software for data collection. Since we are remotely functioning, most of the time we want about department faculty detail, students detail, and so many other information. For the placement time, you will be filtering based on the percentage, backlogs, and based on their domain expertise. For that, you can use Google Form and Google Sheet. So what I'm using is Google Sheet. Google Form demo we will be seeing shortly or tomorrow. So next, these are all the coding practices softwares. So listed for computer science, you can make use of it. 22 softwares or platforms listed here. So using this platform, students can become globally visible also. They can acquire knowledge also. They can improve their coding skill. Then those who don't have stable internet or laptop or mobile, laptop or desktop, they can make use of the mobile using these are all the softwares. C for Droid for C language programming practice, offline software, CPP Droid, Solo Learn. Solo Learn gives a list of languages and they will create content through app, through mobile itself, they can learn. And once if they complete that course, they will conduct a test. Then immediately the test is completed with the required meeting their deadline or their percentage, immediately it will generate the certificate. So with the solo loan, within 10 days or 15 days, we can create a 5 to 10 certificates. You can inform to your students, ENCODE, Code Murai, MIMO. So these are all the list of platforms. Next, English language teaching software, Vishu Words, Macmillan Dictionary, World of Teaching. So this is a bunch of software I'm listing or recommending for English language teachers. Ref and Write, not only English language teachers, anybody wants to learn English, name it, be it your kid, your own kid or your own students or you yourself, anybody wanted to improve your English knowledge. So these are all the varieties or varied softwares freely available. Using this, you can improve the expertise in English. So tools for the list of softwares, this link you need to click, you need to use this link. This link will give you list of software for science, maths, geography, astronomy, etc. So here it is listed, geography and astronomy, language training, mathematics. You need to explore, because I'm not exploring this based on the domain and all. I don't know anything about mathematics so much. So mathematics teachers need to sit and explore these all, and you can make use of somebody would have created some manuals or videos. So these are all the software for science education. Specifically, it is mentioned which subject, virtual lab simulation, then programming, memorizing softwares. So these are all the softwares you can make use of it. Then the Buzzer software, buzzin.live, that's it. This is a software you can use. Very simple, teacher need to register, then it will create one code, and that code need to be shared among students. Then it will enroll the name of students, whatever, if they are using their institution mail ID, then roll number will be reflected. If they are using Gmail or personal mail ID, their name will be reflected. Then whomever presses that buzzer button, then that buzzer signal will come. Suppose 600 members are right now available with this workshop. I wanted to ask one question. With this software, who is ready to answer first, immediately you can press the button and you can answer. Then that kind of thing, it is possible. 150 players it allows. Live streaming software, OBS Studio. Live streaming means there is no who is attending, we can't understand. So it will stream lively. Anybody comes to the chat box only, we will understand. Streaming your own video, your own session. So that is OBS, Streamlabs. So these are all the Facebook, Microsoft Team, Google Meet, live stream, and the light stream. Prezi also has a live stream. So these are all you can use. If you want to do YouTube live stream, 1,000 subscribers required or some conditions. Less than 1,000 subscriber through mobile live stream, you can't do. Some conditions are there. This recently yesterday I copied from the Google announcement, or they have guidelines, terms and conditions. So with that, certification. Certify EM. This is the add-on you need to use with the Google form for the certification. At the end of participation, automatically it will generate certification to that. There is a demonstration video given here. Animation software, Animoto, Render Forest, Biteable, Viva Video, this is mobile app, Kinemaster. These are all the four softwares you can make use of for creating a tiny animation videos for your, if you want to say seven different rules, seven different steps for one particular topic, that all you can create with music and seven steps, you can create one tiny animation that will create interest among students when watching your animation than video. The next is Google add-ons. This alone, we need to host 1 week workshop. So Google, before Google add-on, you should understand what is G Suite. G Suite, you need to have one admin for your institution or for your business. So that admin creation, here I have given the video. This is even I am not expertise. Google themselves gives all the demonstration videos and terms and conditions, do's and don't do's, videos for how to create a G Suite account for your institution. These are all the questions yesterday chat box I have received. So I received talk about G Suite madam, talk about Google AdSense, how to generate certificate, how to create animations. Based on your questions, I have brought this all topic. It was not in my syllabus. So you need to go use this YouTube link. This is directly administered by Google. So the Google expert, they have help team, support team, any kind of queries you can ask them than relying on any other expertise. You can directly watch a Google for Education video. These all said to be Google Suite. These are all the products available in the Google Suite. Completely free, easy for collaboration, use on any device. It's a responsive system. Name it tab you are using, our mobile you are using, our laptop you are using, desktop, it which suits for all the devices, responsive system. Then annotation and whiteboard tools. So Jamboard, Canvas, and Zapier. I will show you right now annotation tools, this one. It's interesting. These tools are, in the Zoom itself, say already I created these all simply for namesake. New drawing, I can create. So I can mix now two features I can mix. Zoom also provides a lot of features. Now Canvas apps, Chrome also provides a lot of features. I can mix and match these two features. See, now this I can do any color. I can do the drawing using this. Then other features, you can set the size and opacity of the pen. So accordingly it will change the thickness. The next is you can explore each and every tool and you can do with it. Then pen, so this texture will vary. So you can mix with the Zoom and you can mix with this. It's called image annotation tool. You can bring one image, you can using this, you can import image. The very first option I said new, instead of new, upload image. Then you can annotate, you can start explaining that image parts and labels. You can start giving, this is what this, you can start explaining. So that is the advantage of this one tool. You can annotate. Then next is Jamboard. What is this Jamboard? I just show you. So you can create a plus button. Bottom line, you will see a plus button. You click this plus button. This morning I created this Jamboard. Now my new Jamboard is ready. Look at the pen. Using pen, you can draw something. Then next you can bring one document. This is sticky note. This say which color you want, you can choose. One sticky note, enough. One sticky note, one drawing I made. One image also I can upload. That image from internet, Google Drive. So these all, you can bring in one component. You can share this. You can fix the background also. See, now I'm fixing with blue grid. I can fix with background anything, fill color, whichever you like, choices yours. So this is the way you can decorate. You can create components, different components, images and drawings and text material, sticky notes. These all together, it will create like a board. Then that board untitled jam. Demo. So this board you can share with your students, or you can download it as image and you can share later on. So these are all the features for annotations and whiteboard. There are other 11 whiteboard tools I listed here, you can walk through. Now let us we have half an hour more, we can couple of tools we can explore. So walkthrough of tools are over now. Simultaneously, I started showing demonstration, not going slow pace. Let us start with cooltext.com. A tiny software, whichever tiny software, I'll be explaining all the tiny. So because we have half an hour more, so within that. So the moment you type cooltext.com, that's it. these are URL I listed in the Google sheet. You will be seeing that. If not, just type cool text in the Google. Automatically, it will show the top link as the home page of the cool text. Just click, you will be taken to the cool text. Now, just to walk through the available textures. It is a logo designing software. Most of you are in a brochure, and most of your students will be preparing brochure for your workshops. By the time, these all may be useful. And not only for that, I'll show you the material which the way I prepare. This is the way we need to prepare a material that will create a lot of interest among our students. Readability or cognitive load theory will be applied. I used to give daily digest. Every day I used to give material. So this is one material I'll show you. As much as possible titles we need to give, and much more that I will give you. If you look at the way we prepare, that attention grabbing, so that clarity, where it starts, where it ends, what is the diagram, how we are explaining, that material need to be of this kind. So for that decoration purpose only, these all I am talking about. Visual effects, how we can bring. If we give food for thought at the end of the topic, this is what they need to read. They should know these are all the our answer for this question, or we may need to enable them to think at the end of the session. So the material should have this completeness, aesthetic appeal, where it starts, where it ends, that readability. People should show interest in reading it. So that is what I mean to say. So this is the material, computer language processing system. This I generated using CoolText. So in the introduction slide, my name also I created, that modern teaching learning methods, that also I created using CoolText. You can just go through this, whatever you are seeing, this all animations, these all animations, you should have higher version of Windows. Only then this glittering, this animation will come into your PowerPoint or your Microsoft Word. The lower versions, it's not supporting. That is the only limitation. So other than that, you have few more. Just click this button, walk through. Initially, when you look into the cool text, you will feel excited. So just walk through whichever you like, just pick any one thing. Halloween, type. Krishna University session. You need to wait until that Halloween, need to convert it into Krishna University session. So this is what I'm expecting. Everything will have different image, composite. You need to walk through whatever it enables. Sometimes it allows you to change the font size, colors also. You can add some symbol. See, look at this logo text beneath, you will have add symbol. Click that. It will give you a lot of symbols, whichever the symbol you like. Your whatever is suitable. It's a kind of logo design. If it is university, then I wanted to put like this. So where that one had gone, yeah, one is here. So here number one university, I want to declare something like this. So you can put whatever you want, the symbol, how many symbols you want, or if it is technological university, you can bring some technology symbol. Once things are ready, your decoration is over, whatever you are typing in the logo text box, if it is converted to the texture, once done, create composite. Second step, we need to create composite. Then until it gets loaded here, if we have good internet, it will do better. If not, we need to have patience. So it has come here. Now download, click download. The moment download has come, it will be there. Now here downloaded, show in folder. I'm going, it is showing. Just copy, then come to your document, whichever you want. Just paste. See, Krishna University session has come. Name it Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, or Prezi, any software. You can use this. It is an image file. This image file, it will be creating miniature version. You can resize also. I am not comfortable keeping this much lengthy. So I want to reduce. Yeah, I am reducing. Or I can spread out or spread in. So this is the advantage of CoolText. Next, if you want to do Google.com cheat sheet plus electronic circuits. Click this images. It shows lot of electronic circuits related formula, linear integrated circuits, op-amp diagrams. Here it shows formula and something. Whichever you like, just go through. We can't sit and draw this all. It will take a lot of time for drawing this diagram. So if you look at, if allows you to download, look at this, allows you to download, you download or share with your students. If it is not allowing, type snipping tool. Yeah, already I have opened here snipping tool. So this is snipping tool. Click new. The moment you click new, everything will be disabled. So you need to arrange the screens whichever you want perfectly. Make it clean and neat appearance. Then you click. See, this is the snipping tool. It will have like this. So click this new button. Then it will become disabled. No need to worry. Just crop it. That cropping is also active one or two times if you do. Crop it now. Save it or just edit, copy. I don't want to save. When, right now I want to put it in my Microsoft Word material. I'm collapsing. Let it be. So this has come. So material preparation is over. If you think that these three are the component amplifiers not in your syllabus, leave it. Crop only these three and paste it. So if whatever you are expecting not available, search for several pins or several cheat sheets. So wherever you get, crop that and bring it. Then you will create a collection and a gallery. Similarly, Pinterest also a part. You can use Pinterest instead of cheat sheet also. It will ask you to register if you are beginning, if you are using. This is Pinterest. You need to go to Pinterest and within the Pinterest, you can think of anything what you are expected. Then you can do whatever you want to do, architecture or your subject matter. Nowadays, Pinterest gives a lot of English terminology, synonyms, antonyms. So much it has brought innovativeness for the education also. Not it's initially for fashion world and for... Now, what to say, different social activities for the education also, it is available right now. So next, let us move on to a small software, so because we have limited time today. So all tiny softwares I wanted to discuss. Whichever goes more than half an hour, 45 minutes, so let us move on to tomorrow. Rubrik software, I want to discuss now. See, Ruby Store for teachers. That just we type this word Ruby Star in the internet, then the top link would be this software internet. If you want, I can type and show you. See, all, click all, Ruby Star, click. This is what very first. If you click this, what I am here, you will get the same. So next, create rubric directly, nothing to do with this software. Directly go and click create rubric. Now let us see. Every time it is creating, when I worked, it has come. Just morning I worked, it has come. Yeah, I'll check it out. Tomorrow I'll fix and bring. And go to iRubric also. written report, story writing, science experiment, oral report, which topic, which activity, oral presentation, lab experiment, research project, what kind of activity we want to do. Click that activity, find out. So this is called rubrics. So we need to explain them. I am expecting from my learner, oral presentation, content quality, knowledge, oral presentation, stays on the topic, posture or eye contact. These are all the four, our enthusiasm, audience. They are giving all, we should not put all, pace of delivery. We need to pick 3 to 4 element. Then this is the grading style. If you like this categorical or grading with labels, you can do distinguished. If you don't want, you will say that 100 to 80 mark I will award, 80 to 100 marks I will award if your student desirable to this, or else if you are having 4 attribute, every attribute we can fix 25 25 25 marks, then 20 to 25 marks I will award when this attribute is fulfilled by my student, so that bias free evaluation will happen. Students also will understand where they are weak and where they are strong and how they need to prepare. These rubrics we need to articulate during the announcement itself. Only then students will understand what my teacher is expecting, how I need to get ready for my preparation, how I need to acquire mark, what is the set target I need to score. Then they will have their mental picture or their own ambition to score the grades. So this need to be articulated. Then you will be labeling them as proficient if they have this. If you don't like this kind of grading system, you can put a mark. So I can award 20 to 15 marks, then 15 to 10 marks, less than 10 marks, something like that. So whenever in this component any students gets, you need to create one more Excel sheet. This one sheet we need to create and keep it as a rubrics for oral presentation activity. Date on title, what title we are doing the oral presentation. Then what we need to do, we need to create a Excel sheet in that name list. First attribute, second attribute, third attribute, fourth attribute. Every student, first attribute means content quality, what I am giving. That signifies that student is not good in content or good in content also. Then knowledge. If I am giving 5 marks, that shows that content is good, but knowledge of the delivery is not good. So automatically, I myself will be able to understand how my teacher is grading, where I am lagging. So this is a guideline both for students and teachers for the exchange of closure and reflections. So this is called rubrics. What is the beauty of Ruby Star? It will allow us to customize much more along with the ready-made. Here we will have a PDF document. We need to copy paste and once again customize. Working with Ruby Star is always ace, and I will come out with that link when I am using in the mobile. It is working. The moment that link I am bringing to the web, it is creating PHP error. I need to work it out. Twice I faced this problem. So these are all the things you may need to practice for today. And I want to show flashback recorder. Flashback recorder, once it is installed, then it is easy for recording. Then after that, we may need to convert. Flashback recorder will create a video in different file format that need to be converted into MP4, MP5. That is only one more step you need to do for the final video release. After that flashback recorder video format converted to MP4, MP5 only, you can upload either into Edpuzzle or you can watch through video media player or you can give it to YouTube archival. So that is another thing. Otherwise, tomorrow we can discuss. Kannan sir, shall we go for QA session for another 5-10 minutes? Then shall we wind up the session today?
Yes, please. You can go ahead.
Yeah, I request right now, if you have any technical questions, so as per today discussion, please post plagiarism checker software. Yeah, I'll try, I'll collect tomorrow. If it is possible, I'll bring. If not, mostly it is licensed version only available. I will check it out and I will collect the plagiarism software. Tomorrow I will give you. Otherwise, in my education for empowerment, I have listed out. It is available. Plagiarism check software and softwares for research writing. These are all those things I have done in it. Please go ahead. No more doubts. Yeah. Then fine. Thank you. how to register in iPad? I don't have iPad. I don't have that experience. 1 minute. It's going very fast. Thank you. I will announce all your emotional expressions after 10 minutes. Now let us move on for the discussion, sir. Plagiarism check tomorrow I'll bring. Yeah, many of you, language editing of review or research articles. Reverso, R-E-V-E-R-S-O, Reverso is one of the language editing tool I used to use. Edpuzzle.com to know the accountability, showing accountability. Edpuzzle will bring accountability. Free statistical software, you can use Vika and you can use Orange, Python, R, these all are free. Let us wait for appreciation or thank you. Please, you type about, PPT I will give you. All there is a Prezi link share, that share you can't download and all. You can even use my presentation and you can present, but that you can't change anything. You can see my slide on your laptop instead of my laptop, you will see. Yeah, hands on tomorrow we will be doing, because all the softwares 40 minutes, 45 minutes that I cannot do today. That's why I'm limiting. I will maximum today's recorded session and tomorrow session also I'll be uploading into YouTube. No worries. Yeah, PPT, recorded video, everything will be given. Assessment software, tomorrow I will be administering and I will be demonstrating lot of assessment softwares, don't worry. Quizzy, Mentimeter and Kahoot. Kahoot video already I have created. I don't do Kahoot. In my YouTube channel, recently, the previous workshop, all the participants, I conducted assessment test. Immediately they were excited and they were asking Kahoot to teach. By the time session was over, that was the last activity.
Slow and steadily.
I'm sharing my Kahoot link. One minute, if you stop for chat, I will share with you everyone. Speech assessment you can't do, sir. You only need to do speech assessment. This is for Kahoot. So you today itself you learn Kahoot and practice it. Don't wait for my session for tomorrow. Your exercise started, your homework started. So tomorrow, whatever we possible, we can do. English paragraph editing software, that is what Reverso. Reverso is sufficient. Ref and write. That all the softwares I listed in the English language teaching. Other teachers also go through the English section. Writing skill software. Writing skill software, nothing is available. We need to write and we need to put it in the software. It will suggest. Try Google Translator, you can use Makesh sir. Translating one language to another language, Google Translator. Google itself. Nowadays, so many friends I'm having from Bangalore and Karnataka and here in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. They will be translating different languages. They don't know Telugu, but they will be using typing English and they will take Telugu equivalent and they will be posting. It's possible. Any language, anywhere we can communicate. Article rewrite software, ref and write. I will show you. Most of you are interested research related only. I guess rather than teaching learning practices, I'll show you. Reverso will be helpful. See, ref and write, imitative learning. It you can use. Note it, ref and write. Just to type, you Google ref and write. Reverso you can use for your grammatical check. Google, you just type, these are all the words. Scopus indexed journal software. Madam, this is not research workshop, madam. This is educational practices, pedagogical practices. I will share one YouTube video. I hope so. It will be useful. Around one day workshop, which I conducted at JNTU Hyderabad, that I made of 45 minutes video. I think so you may feel useful. So you just watch this video. It's equivalent to one day attending workshop. So all the contents are provided. Research related stuff. After watching that video, if anything is required, we will do. We request Kahoot password address, nothing is required. Kahoot, you use your own Google login. Please watch my YouTube video, step by step. Even beginner, very new to computer also can able to understand. My Kahoot video, please watch it. There is no password, I no need to give. Physics experiment virtual demonstration software. Yesterday I shared the link. If you are in WhatsApp group, you can able to see. YouTube channel name, just to go to YouTube, Dr. Lakshmi, my YouTube name, I kept my own name. That's it. Dr. Lakshmi space D. That's it. This is my YouTube channel name. Or else I'm sharing the link several times. I'm sharing. If you are not in WhatsApp group, please join the WhatsApp group. All the correspondence communications, WhatsApp admin will be communicating with you all then and there. Civil engineering model, I don't know, sir. I'm computer science. I don't know anything about civil engineering. That domain specific related. We will be shortly, I personally going to launch workshops for civil software related, English software related, maths. That domain specific I will speak. I will communicate. I have you all of your mail ID. I will communicate. If you are interested, you can join with a nominal fees. That's it. Only 100 rupees, 200 rupees I may charge. Per participant. Recorded video we will be giving, sir, no need to worry. Add my number, your number I may not able to add. WhatsApp admin number I will share and you can do it. Excuse me, my mobile. I will share WhatsApp admin number. You can approach, you just text, don't trouble him a lot. Past 3-4 days he is into lot of tension. So just a gentle message you put and he himself will be respond, adding into any one of the group. So WhatsApp admin for this Krishna University workshop. Soon after the workshop, by 8 o'clock, at the maximum 8 o'clock, I will be sharing all the materials. No worries. You please note it down. For making animated content, that is what I said, no ma'am, animation. See, exclusively I brought for animation software. Animoto, Render Forest, Kinemaster. Viva video. I show you the animation software which I used. That is Render Forest. This is the video. You can watch. So this kind of animation you can create. There is one more animation software also. This is what I listed here. Whatever I used only I'm listing here. Kinemaster, Viva Video, this is for mobile app. You can mix and match several videos together. You can create one image and mix with music. That all possible, you need to explore. How to create Google Form. Tomorrow 45 minutes I'll be talking about Google Form and its ad answer. Don't worry. Can we subscribe? Of course, you please subscribe. That is what I am expecting, a gift of you all for this workshop. Subscribe my channel. Anytime I release a video, you will get a notification. That link also will be remembered. Molecular models, I'm not sure, sorry. Software creating NBA related summaries. NBA related summaries, there are several vendors selling NBA related softwares. I know so many softwares. There only you need to do. Here I am not doing any software for NBA related summaries and all. Google Form I will be doing tomorrow. For drawings and molecular structure, you may use Lucid Chart. I am typing in the chat box. Lucid Chart. L-U-C-I-D, Lucid Chart. You can use for drawing. Upload my video lecture in Google Classroom. Yes, Google Classroom will accept video lecture. But accountability, who watched your video, who are all students cheating you, that you can't track. But the same video, if you bring to Edpuzzle, it will take care. you can put it in YouTube or you can keep it in your desktop and bring to Edpuzzle. That will give all that. Tomorrow Edpuzzle, definitely 45 minutes demonstration. Quizlet, some half an hour demonstration. Google Classroom, half an hour demonstration. Google Form, half an hour demonstration. There are a few more softwares, Mentimeter, Quizzy, and SoCreate. Few more software we will be exploring. Finally, Kahoot, I will be conducting test for you, assessment. So that Kahoot, I don't teach you. Because that video I have created, please watch from my YouTube channel. Today itself, all of you need to do Kahoot, being a teacher. You can use your own kids or your family members, that Kahoot code you can share with them, play, conduct some test, some short test, which is fruit, something, a funny question you create, and do it today. Yes, zoology diagram, I don't know, sir. Zoology, internet, you can copy paste. Nowadays, everything is available on internet. The body anatomy, brain anatomy, digestive system, everything is available. Accounting software, I don't know. Please, I am into computer science. I know only educational software, sir. 23 title I have brought. Within that, you ask me. Tools for mathematics, so much I had given. It is available. See, tools for mathematics I have brought. And today also I explored few software for mathematics. I'll show you. See, this is the software. Today I explored. It is too good. This one. Code Cox. Computing, Math, Statistics, Engineering, Finance, Unit, Strings, Physics available. If you want to bring mathematical equations into Google Form, this is a link you need to merge with your Google Form. Code Cox, Max Teacher, you need to use of it. See, Equation Editor, explore. It has so much feature. I don't know, physics teacher, you need to sit and explore this website, codecox.com. Your duty. I don't know anything about physics, so I cannot use this software. I can introduce to you. Unit, strings, finance related, accounting, somebody asked, no, use this link. And there is another link also for economics teachers. It is available. Engineering, statistics, maths, computing. So this, you need to click this equation editor. Click this. It will easily allow you to create a lot of equations. Yesterday, somebody asked in the chat box how to create equation. That because of that question only explode. After your session, I explored this software. Till then, I was not knowing. You come down. The ready-made equations, if you want, you can use. Or else click this equation editor. For existing equation editor, click this. See, this is the editor. Pick what kind of equation you want. Use this and type. It is easy to use. This equation URL you can bring to the Google Form. Normally, maths teachers feels that Google Form is unfit for using for them. So they will be finding difficult for creating equations. Better use codecox.com, create equation here, bring that to the Google Form. How to access Kahoot? Wait, I will show you Kahoot. You watch my video that I'm telling, you are asking now itself. If you ask now itself, I'll show you now itself. Wait a minute. This is the Kahoot link. Kahoot.com. Just type Kahoot in the internet. That will take you easily. Kahoot.com. That is another issue, sir. Chitalu, sir. Rural area, this lot of teachers complained to me. Whenever I conduct a workshop, these virtual workshops, they personally call, my students are not affordable for the mobile and many are living in the rural place. How to do? I don't have a solution for this, sir. Really, I'm sorry. Either government need to take some steps or your institution need to take some steps. So most of the softwares are online only. If not, you need to provide through WhatsApp or mail or somehow you need to send the material, let them learn. That is the thing. Equation, how to bring it to on Google Form. Tomorrow I will sell Dr. Krishnaveni, madam. Tomorrow I will tell you. Just I'm introducing. If you are having more curiosity, please. Software for psychometric testing. I myself developed a software for psychometric testing. Know your caliber. If you want, let us collaborate later on. Please share Google Sheet. I'll share you, madam. Don't worry. Virendra, sir, I will share you with the Google Sheet and my praises presentation. Snipping cheat sheet. Snipping is a tool to crop, madam. Snipping is a tool to crop part of the video, part of the document, part of the image. The snipping is a part of your Microsoft product. And cheat sheet is an internet product. What is WordPress? WordPress is a kind of blog. You can write a blog. I will show you my blog. See, blogger.com. I do have 4 or 5 blogs, but I don't write anything. Blogger.com. See, educational thoughts. This is my dashboard. So health tips and one more blog and the web education. There are 5-6 blogs I'm having. So you need to go here. This, it's a kind of WordPress has different template, different conditions, terms. Blogger is a product of Google. It is free to use. I am not even single paise, but my content is more, viewers are more. Monetization will become very, tiny monetization will come. That too, it has some conditions. These many viewers are need to be there. The blog, age of the blog should be these many months, and the articles of the blog should be these many. After fulfillment of these all conditions, you can create blog. This is called blog. It's kind of WordPress is equivalent to that. I'm not expertise in WordPress. I don't have, but WordPress is much more powerful and aesthetic appeal than blog. What is the difference is blog won't allow you to customize. They will have different template Google enforce. You need to use about the same. Otherwise, WordPress will give you a lot of aesthetic appeal. Following link to, now, you need to go for plagiarism software. Within this blog itself, I have listed plagiarism software. See, I started December 2017, 3 articles, 4 articles. Somewhere in this month, if you archive educationforempowerment.blogspot.com, somewhere it is available. Plagiarism tool and free Scopus journal, educational journal, something I have archived, research related stuff. You go through it. Otherwise, tomorrow I'll bring that plagiarism software. Draw the graphics. Lucid chart, I said, no, sir. Lucid chart you can use for drawing. Life science tools. Quizlet is a software useful for life science. Tomorrow I will be showing you, madam. Don't worry. Now, personal safety, Zoom. They have improved the security. It's up to your personal opinion, sir. Sitalu, sir. It's up to your opinion. It's your problem. Whether you want to use Zoom or not, we should have decision making, our courage and boldness. Nothing can go beyond our control. Don't worry, we are all not VVIPs to do something with us. Yeah, LaTeX for mathematical equations you can use. Online LaTeX is also available. No need to download nowadays. LaTeX made online to create your equation. Chartboard and all, not this. I will be hosting artificial intelligence workshop. Please come to there, madam. I got one participant, Anumala. You can come there. I will talk about chatbot. Software for sports science. Never I play any game. I don't know about sports, please. Yeah, with this, we almost reached 5 o'clock. I thank you all for your enthusiastic participation. Kahoot will support mobile. Don't worry. How to create one blog? Just do create one Gmail account, blogger.com. Type, then you go. If you want, maybe in a couple of weeks, I will be, if I am free from workshops, a series of workshops I'm having after Krishna University, I'll be having for JNTU Hyderabad. So if I am free, I will create every day one video, how to create a blog from the beginning. And whatever your request, all your chat history, we will be recording, but I can't do, I can't promise immediately I will do. Most of your question, I can promise within 2 to 3 months of duration, you may get answers from my YouTube channel or from my blog. Google advanced, there is no advanced search, just to put and search. If you are expecting more than one combination, you need to use plus symbol. That's it. PyCharm, yeah, good idea. Then PyCharm, go for Anaconda. Anaconda is best. Anaconda will bring Spider IDE, and this PyCharm will suck a lot of internet. Don't use PyCharm. Either Jupyter Notebook or go for online Kaggle or Google Co-Laboratory, Google Colab. So these all, yeah, almost we have come to the concluding session. Thank you so much. and come with more energy tomorrow. All I request all of you, please watch Kahoot today itself. One software, you be thorough on it. Any doubt regarding Kahoot, let us discuss 5 minutes tomorrow, but don't expect me to explain, because other softwares I have set agenda. Whatever the promises we made in the instruction manual, that only we will do. Prezi software also I will do. If you are expecting too much, it is not possible to do tomorrow. So watch that Kahoot software today itself, practice it. You administer one small assessment. I'm not getting audio. I cannot do anything. You check at your end. This maximum audibility volume I'm raising. Beyond that, I can't do anything. Yeah. There is a survey. Survey Monkey link is shared by the moderator. Please, all of you, take part in the survey at the end of the day one workshop. Tomorrow we will be discussing about day two workshop. And I will be sharing whatever the yesterday material I shared, I will share this all. Krishna University workshop, pre-workshop material. That also I will share here. Please take care of these links. Survey Monkey link and this link. Your attendance considered based on Survey Monkey, and that's it. Polling already over. Now Survey Monkey. Now note down yesterday material I shared. So yesterday, those who have not taken part in our pre-workshop session, we were doing 1 hour session yesterday. So you, if you would have missed it, you can use this link for whatever I insisted yesterday.
We have completed the survey feedback. You can leave. If there are any questions, the chat window will be opened in another 2 or 3 minutes. After that, you can post your questions. There may or may not be answers, but we'll collect the questions and provide answers at the earliest possible opportunity. Thank you, everyone, for the participation.
Thank you, sir, for the end note. Thank you all for your active participation. We are looking forward with more enthusiasm for tomorrow's session also. Good night, all of you. Sir, may I stop share?
Yes, please, you can stop the share.